This led to the natural development where there was a goal of trying to unify these various techniques together, which led to the unified modeling language, UML. There's an industry group called the Object Management Group, called OMG, that is the home for this standardization effort. It's where you can find the specification documents, which I refer you to during the course of the term. UML has also been championed by IBM. They acquired a company called Rational, which had developed a development environment called Rational Rose, which supported directly UML. There's lots of such case tools now. Aside from Rational Rose, one that we've used is Enterprise Architect. Now, these are commercial tools. There are also all kinds of drawing tools out there which you can get for free. UML itself had three main architects. One was Rumbaugh, one was Grady Booch, and the other was Ivor Jacobson. Okay? They're sometimes called the Three Amigos. They produced, in addition to the Unified Modeling Language itself, three books, a reference manual, a user's guide, and so on, that had as main authors each one of the three, and together conveyed the overall approach to UML. It's important to note at this stage that the UML diagrams can be used both for design but also for analysis. And I'll try to distinguish as we go forward whether we're talking about an analysis diagram or a design diagram. The main distinction is analysis is concerned with the problem being solved and design is concerned with the solution to that problem. I've taken some of these diagrams you're about to see from the UML reference manual and from the UML user's guide.